Hello and welcome back. Today we're going to talk about a new topic from group theory. It is called group homomorphism. So what is that concept? So let me talk about that. So suppose we have a group, one group G, and with an operation. So suppose we have G is a group. Suppose we have another group G dash, and with another operation. So what is that? What we want to associate the elements of this group. So elements of this group to the elements of this group. This is our motivation. So we're going to associate the elements of these sets to the elements of another set. So we know that we have already have a tool which is called a mapping, by which we can associate the member of the set G to the member of the set G dash. But what we're going to do, so here basically G is not only a set but with has an algebraic structure with a binary operation. So G is a group and G dash, which is not only a non-empty set, which is also has an algebraic structure. So what we're going to do, our task is to, so motivation behind not only to associate the elements of the group G to the elements of the group G dash, but we want to preserve the structure of G. Motivation for the mapping. So motivation that we want to preserve, we want to preserve group structure or algebraic structure. So here is the group structures. So we want to preserve the structures. So this is one of our motivation to define a mapping. So in such a way, so which means that suppose we have two elements. So what is the meaning? What is the word preserve group structure means? What I am saying that suppose we have two elements A and B from the group G, and if we compose these two elements A compose B in G, we get another elements in the group G. So you can see over here, if I have a set G over here, and here we have another set which is G dash. So here we have one element A, other element is B, and here we have the elements A compose B. So what we're going to do, suppose we map these elements A compose B, so we can map these elements A compose B by the mapping phi. So that means we get an element phi of A compose B in the group G dash. And our motivation is that we going to have, so suppose if we map only the elements A, we get phi of A over here. So A also map to, by this mapping, to phi of A, and B is also map this mapping phi to get an elements phi of B over here. So phi of A and phi of B are not two elements in the group G dash. So what we have, we want to share that that it have to be equals to A compose B have to be equals to phi of A star phi of B. So what is the meaning of that? Meaning of that, so if we have two elements, so it's in the one way to say that if we have two elements in the group G, show that if I first compose these two elements, so we first doing some binary operations over here, then transfer this element. So first, so let me erase this part and talk about it more fresh way. So here we have an elements A and B from the group G. So and then we do the operation, so A compose B. And if I transfer, so if I map the elements after operation, so first we operate these two elements and then we map, which have to be same with if I first map these two elements. So map the two elements, we get phi of A and phi of B, and then compose. These have to be same. So phi of A Now the compose star over here, because we have defined star is our compositions in GDAS, so they have to be equal. So yep. Two elements, if we first compose, then transfer, or first transfer, then compose, they will be the same. So the text, the structure is preserved also over here, in the sense that the meaning that if I first compose, then transfer, or first transfer, then compose, they give the same value. So the structure is basically preserved over here. So this is the meaning. So let me write the definition. What is the more formal way? What is the definition of group homomorphism? So remember that first compose, then transfer, or the transfer means the mapping, which is same as first we map, then compose, will be gives the same results. So the all the way, so we do first compose and second transfer, or first transfer, then compose, they give the same answer. So let me write down the definition over here. So here is the definition of group homomorphism. So let G with a composition and G dash with another composition be two group, be two groups. Then a mapping, then a mapping. So we are talking about mapping. So we have a function. Then a mapping phi from G to G dash is called a homomorphism, is called a homomorphism, also called a group homomorphism, if phi of A composition B, so this is the composition in the group A composition B, which is same as phi of A compose, now it's the composition of G dash, phi of A composition, phi of B, and this have to be true for all elements A, B belongs to G. So for all A, B, these compositions, so these two have to be followed, then we'll say that the mapping phi is a group homomorphism. So let me give you some example of group homomorphism. Then we will talk about a few more definitions in this direction. So I think you understand what is called a group homomorphism, and I think you also understand the motivation behind the concept of homomorphisms. Here we are going to basically piece up the structure, and we have an example. So suppose we are taking the group G, which is the set of integers with addition, and another group which is G dash, which is suppose the set of real number plus with additions, and let me define the mapping phi from J to R by simply by taking very simple map. So phi of x equals to 2 into x, so phi of x equals to 2 into x, this is our mapping. So how it is mapping is defined. So if I take any elements 2, it's going to be 4. If so, this is how the mapping is defined. So if I have put any value, so phi of minus 2 goes to 2 into minus 2, which is going to gives minus 4, phi of minus 3, which is 2 into minus 3, which is going to 6, phi of 100, which is 200. In that way the mapping is defined. So you can clearly see that this is a mapping from J to the set of real number R. So now what we're going to show, we show that this is a example of group homomorphisms. So what we have to check, we have to check that for any two elements A, B of the say, group G, which is same with phi of A plus phi of B, because here addition is a composition in both case G and G dash. So over here, so what we're going to do, so let's take two elements. So let x1 and x2 are two integers. So what we're going to have, So if we have two integers, first we add these two integers, so we get x1 plus x2, then compose, then transfer this integer, so we are taking the mapping, so phi of x1, x2, so this gives 2 of x1, x2, which is 2x1 plus 2x2. Now what we're going to do, first we transfer the elements x1 or the take the mapping. So phi of x1 is 2x1. What about phi of x2? Phi of x2 is 2x2. Now we're going to add these two. So phi of x1 plus phi of x2, which is 2 of x1 plus 2 of x2. So 2 of, you can see that which is same as phi of x1 plus x2. And this is true for all because I choose x1 and x2 arbitrarily, any two elements of z. So it's true for all x1 and x2. So phi is, so define the given phi. So phi is here, is one of the group homomorphisms. So phi is an example of group homomorphism. So example of group homomorphism. So group homomorphism. So this is one of our example. Let me give you another example of group homomorphism. So what we're going to do in this way, then we'll talk about an example where it is not a group homomorphism. So first of all, okay, first let me give you an example which is not a group homomorphism. Then we'll go to another example where it is group homomorphism. So, again, suppose this is our same group. Now, let me define a mapping from J to R by the following rule that phi of x goes to x plus 1. So, how this map is defined? So, if I put any value 2, it goes to 2 plus 1, which is 3. If I put phi of 0, it goes to 0 plus 1, which is 1. In this way, the mapping is defined. You can, I think you can clearly understand how the map is defined. So what we have to check, is this follow the group homomorphism or not? So is phi of x1 plus x2 is same as phi of x1 plus phi of x2 for all x1 and x2 belongs to Z or not? So for example, let me take that any two elements. So let's choose x1 and x2 belongs to Z. So what we do, we first add these two, x1, x2, then transfer this or the map these two elements. So phi of x1, x2, which is basically x1 plus x2. You can see that if we have x, so it will be x plus 1. So here the x is x1 plus x2. And so it will be x1 plus x2 plus 1. So now what about phi of x1? So phi of x1 is x1 plus 1. What is phi of x2? Phi of x2 is x2 plus 1. So now if we add phi of x1 plus phi of x2, it goes to x1 plus 1 plus x2 plus 1. So we get x1 plus x2 plus 2. So you can definitely sure, for sure that this is x1 plus x2 plus 2, and here we get x1 plus x2 plus 1. So this is clearly not equal to phi of x1 plus x2. So this mapping defined in this way is not a group homomorphism. So this is an example of non-example, or they say that example where we have a mapping but it's a not group homomorphism, not a homomorphism, not a homomorphism. So this is our example of not a group homomorphism, of an example of a mapping. Okay, let's talk about one of another example. Then in next video we talk about a few more example and more observations in this direction. So let me, instead of these two group, I am taking two. simple to groups. For example, I'm just taking group. So what we're going to do, we'll take the group G, which is the group which is 1 minus 1 I and minus Y with under multiplication. So G under multiplication is a group. So G under multiplication is our group. And let me define a mapping. So from here, so G dash is also G. So G dash here also I'm taking G and define the same mapping. So basically define a mapping G from G cross to G cross. So same group, the mapping between same group. How the mapping is defined? I define mapping in such a way that it's going to the same element. So X going to have the same X, which means phi of 1 going to have phi 1, phi of minus 1 going to minus 1, phi of I going to I, and phi of minus I going to be minus I. That's how the mapping is defined. In this way, this mapping is defined. So what we have to do, we have to check this is a group homomorphism or not. You can see that now. Let clearly that take any two x1 and x2, two elements from G. If I do take the composition, so x1 to x2, then take the mapping. So phi of x1 and x2, we get x1 into x2. And if I first map, so we get phi of x1, which is x1, and next we map phi of x2, we get x2. Now if we take these two compositions, so phi of x1 into phi of x2, we obviously get again x1, x2, which is same as phi of x1 into x2. So this is another example of group homomorphism. So this is example of group homomorphism. So group homomorphism. So in this way, we can define different group homomorphism between two groups. So where we see that this is preserves the structures, algebraic structures.
Thank you for watching. We will, in the next video, we're going to take up another examples, and from there we'll talk about a few more concepts over these directions.